Hi, my name's Eric, and I'm a doctor. I'm a board-certified internal medicine physician, and I'm here to tell you that the phrase late-term abortion is a made-up phrase. It is not a medical term. It is made up by the pro-force birth movement to scare people. The facts are that the majority of abortions that occur in the United States occur within the first trimester. Abortions occurring later in pregnancy, that is during the second and third trimesters, are exceedingly rare and make up around 1% of total abortions. And let's be clear, women are not waiting until their eighth, ninth month of pregnancy to decide, you know what, I've had enough, I don't want this baby anymore, I'm going to go walk into a Planned Parenthood and just get an abortion and then go to Chili's for a margarita. Doesn't happen. When these abortions occur later in pregnancy, they are almost always in the case of something catastrophically going wrong with the pregnancy. The baby has a fatal anomaly that is not compatible with life, or the mother's health is in danger. And these are very involved, oftentimes surgical procedures that no one's just going to go through just for funsies. And while we're on the topic, no one, and I mean no one, is executing babies after birth. That is called infanticide, and spoilers, it's illegal in all 50 states. What Donald Trump is perseverating on is that if a baby is born with a fatal anomaly that is not compatible with life and it is dying, the parents are given options. They can choose to have the doctors work to resuscitate the baby, that is, put it on life support, do CPR, or if they decide that they don't want their baby to suffer, they could opt for palliative measures, put the baby on hospice, make it comfortable, and allow it to pass away naturally, peacefully, without pain. That is not execution. That is humane and evidence-based healthcare. Please stop letting a deranged lunatic like Donald Trump tell you lies about healthcare. Please register to vote and make sure this man never becomes president of the United States again.